Yeah, and the question, which actually might, sorry, on member observation, we've not just got one accountant here, two. So the question I'm going to ask is a particular person. There's table two, which is described as budget information, and that's really what my question was about. Because in a way, it's not budget information, it's actual expenditure. Sorry, this is income. And I just wonder, thinking of what our role is as a committee that meets three or four times a year, I wonder whether there is a case for having a budget table. And in other words, this table, looking at the previous three quarters as well as the most recent one, is useful. But I would have thought there's also a case for having the final column compared with the budget for the quarter one of this current year. And also, perhaps in summary form, the expenditure, because I can't remember, I thought I told them, but maybe we had that at the last meeting, which was sort of annual meeting. But I would have said there is a case for this committee being aware on a quarterly basis whether income is, and expenditure, is high or low against budget. So, questions in the head, but also to the two finance officers, maybe.
Yeah. Yeah, there's no problem. I'd say we facilitate the summary position being included. Obviously, the reason we include the income is because that's the one that's most fluctuated.
Yeah.
Obviously, the majority of the budget on expenditure is veterinary fees, yeah, which links into the income, the inspections, and the staffing costs. Yeah. So we can do that for the members' information. No problem at all.
I mean, it's really for you, Chair, and members, yeah, generally, but I think it helps us fulfil our role of sort of monitoring. You know, I mean, we're not running the show, but we're the people who hold the team to account, and having that information I think would be helpful. I mean, what one reason would be, there's four quarters there. I'm sure there is to some extent a seasonal element. A budget on income should reflect the normal expected seasonal variations. And the fact that, if you like, it's actually slightly higher than what's going on, but that may be simply, that's what the seasonal variation is, whereas the budget comparison, actual budget varies, would actually disclose whether things are actually on the up, on the down, or perfectly okay. So I would welcome that, Chair, if that's okay with you.
Yeah, I think, as I said, if I turn to page 9, we look at non-animal origin, the second table on page 9, if you look at the third halfway down, the tonnage, literally, can vary so much. That's what I was to say. It's very, you can't forecast the tonnage that's going through. So we tend to look at its overall quantum. Some will be up, some will be down, but that's the key table for.
There is a scene, Alan, but also it depends on the field and their business and how they attract ships to come in. And it's, you know, that's always a challenge, is it not, the code? I mean, we've got many times with appeals to try and understand their business and what they're telling them. But the reality is that importers are becoming a bit more savvy, so they're being larger consignments in one hit. We're only going to charge up to 100 tonnes. So we have a cap on our jars that we can charge for goods coming in. A huge amount of goods coming in that are not of non-animal origin, we can't charge, but we have the duty to check. So it's a complex issue, and I'm sure during the tour today, then going on the code, we'll discuss some of the things that happened within the board, because you'll be able to see it a bit better around the port. So, you don't see the port, you only see it from the water, or you're lucky enough just to be at it. But within the confines of the port, there's a lot to have activity to go on. But it is dependent on shipping, on when shipping arrives. So it does fluctuate quarterly. We have had for some time a down the trend because of the economics. Uncertainty in the Brexit is another factor. So, you know, we are trying to balance the boots, and that's where Tim comes in and his team to ensure that we stay on track and try and maintain our level that we preset the authority course, but it's not always possible to maintain that, and that may be more difficult in the future. A lot depends on what happens with Peel. Superport number 2, which has really not seen any significant ships in at this particular moment. I know Peel have appointed a new
officer director?
Director of operations to try and address that situation around ships contract trade normally going to other ports or to local, but it's not going to be, I'm sure, during the process of the next 12 months or so, we'll keep you informed where we go.
Thank you. Can I then, is there any more questions on?
Yes.
Yes, it's something probably existing members have known for a long time. But all this really, as I understand it, relates to cargoes. But we have an increasing number of course of cruise ships coming in. Fortunately, nothing to do with this country, but there have been some terrible outbreaks of food poisoning, the Chira virus in ships leaving America. What do we do about, do we have any responsibility for cruise lines? Do we exercise it, and do we charge very wealthy companies for what we do on them?
In response to that, in terms of international health regulations, we have responsibility. There is a provision in the international health regulations that vessels have to apply for free critique when they arrive into the country. So if they have a known communicable disease or anyone on board that's ill, they would have to notify Port Health. With regards to the international health regulations, a control measure that's in place, or a monitoring measure, is a ship sanitation inspection. Our vessels are required to have a ship sanitation inspection every 6 months, and then they are issued with a certificate if they comply with the requirements of the ship sanitation, which considers things like food safety, communicable disease, or any public health issues. It's up to the vessel to ask the port, so there's not a requirement to have it every port, and it only when the ship sanitation certificate is due. With regards to the cruise terminal, we have a risk assessment in place. So we're aware all vessels that arrive into the port of Liverpool, and we require them to notify us crucial information so that we can risk assess them. If a vessel arrives into the cruise terminal or port of Liverpool for the first time, we have, from a risk rating basis, will inspect that vessel. If they've already been into the port beforehand, we just assess it from the information, and we actually have a ship's database that rates things from the RAG system, so red, amber, green, and that will then determine to the officers whether they need to routine board the vessel, whether there's concerns because they've not submitted the relevant information that we would require to assess the public health risk, and then we will inspect on that. So with regards to the cruise, there have been a number of cruise vessels that have arrived and we've inspected them for the first time, or we would just monitor them routinely.
And do they appear then in some of the figures here for sanitary tests?
The section that says officers have actioned ship information, that relates to the notification. With regards to table or point 2.71, it details information there about ship sanitation visits, so they can request, and then obviously if we found a problem, we will issue the ship sanitation exemption certificate. Yeah. And yes, we do charge them. The charging scheme is set so it's consistent throughout the whole of the UK.
Thanks.
Any
further questions? No? We'll go over every call. And that's good. We'll not answer. And we'll then move on to the agenda item 4. Schedule the dates. My members have put that in their diary.
Yeah, there was concern about the venue on the Wirral last time. That wasn't addressed. We're interested in this as well, and the venues for Wirral. So we'll be in touch probably in the next few weeks. We might need to get early notice of the venues. At this stage, and with the permission of the committee, there's an additional item of business which needs to be raised. That relates to the operation and governance and maintenance of the port at present. Now, this also includes amounts of financial implications for the Port Authority and will be available today from the Chief Port Health Officer. In view of the nature of the information to be discussed with yourselves, I will seek your consent as a committee to consider that business under the provisions of Schedule 12A, Paragraph 3 of the Local Government Act 1972, which means we exclude press and public from this particular part of the meeting.
Just on that, that's with the Mersey councillors. We see that quite often. I think it has a bit saying on the grounds are whatever. Would you say that the
specific grounds are the financial implications of the state's legal preamble? Yeah. So essentially, we're dealing with financial implications which are impacting the operational and government's arrangements of the Port Authority and such that they are of the nature that need to be confidential at this point in time.
Would that be, if you like, effectively commercial confidentiality?
And the matters you're asking for.
There's a table here. The law of the land is meetings like this are open to the public unless there are a very limited number of reasons. And we've already discussed in public a thing with financial implications. That table was financial.
If I can also add it to you, the reasons for excluding press and public are governed under Schedule 12 by the Government Act 1972 as amended. Yeah. There are approximately 7 paragraphs, but the paragraph we're dealing with specifically here is paragraph 3. That relates to the financial and operational arrangements of the court beyond those covered in the operational cycle report, which you referenced in that table. The specific matters we're going to deal with don't deal with individual financial elements, they deal with operational arrangements with direct impact on the financial income generation opportunities and expenditure potential, which will impact the port directly. Hence, the basis for the request.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's fine, yes.
And that's clear for you. So, is that clear, so you don't have to shout?
Yes, yeah. I mean,
Chair and members of the committee, and I do appreciate members taking the opportunity to actually speak up clearly because the room is of the nature that the acoustics are quite poor, so I do actually appreciate that myself, certainly. In terms of practicality,